Hallelujah. Put your hands together for the Greater Love Gospel Choir. Why don't you lift your hands? Let's pray for the presence of God. Right by my side, you are here, oh Lord. Your presence. I feel your presence, Lord. That's what I need. That's what I'm looking for. I want to find you. I want to know you. Everybody, close your eyes. Lift up your hands. Pray for the presence of God. Pray for the presence of God. Pray for the presence of God. The scripture says, I will be found of you. I will be found of you. I want you to find me. This is what the Lord says to you. You will seek me and you will find me when you search for me with all your heart. Everybody, lift up your hands, close your eyes, and just pray for the presence of God for your life, for your calling, for your ministry, for your days here on earth. Pray for the Lord to be with you, to guide you. Pray for his voice to direct you, to be present in your life. Right by your side. That I am. I want to feel the presence of God standing right by me. Standing. Sing it with me. Right by my side. You are here, oh Lord. Your presence, Lord. That's what I need. That is what.
That's why.
blessed to hear from you. Holy Spirit, move. Holy Spirit, have your way. Holy Spirit, we have nothing but you. We want to hear your voice. We want to know your presence. We want to come closer to you. We don't want to serve a God we've heard about. We want to know you. We want to find you. We want to discover who you are. I pray here at this service that you introduce yourself to those of us who don't know you, and to those of us who have met you, bring us closer to you. Thank you for your anointing. Thank you for your presence. Let your word have free course. Change our lives. Let us know your love. Let us come closer to you. Let us love you more. Let us serve you more. Let us give ourselves to you more. But without you, we can do nothing. But with you, all things are possible. And we thank you for this blessed time in your presence. In Jesus' name I pray. And everyone said, amen. Put your hands together. You may be seated. Oh, do you love the Holy Spirit? Are you blessed to be in the house of God? Oh, are you alive? The Holy Spirit is going to change your life. The Holy Spirit is going to transform your life. Amen. We've been looking at flowing with the anointing. And today we want to discuss the wind of the Spirit. The wind, and I'm going to preach for 20 minutes and we'll be out of here. But I believe God has something powerful to say to you. The wind of the Spirit. I said, will you sing that third verse again? Allow us to sing when we want to sing, okay? I hope it's okay with you. At the back, is it okay with you there? Sing the third verse again. We're talking about the wind. Sing it.
Right by my side, here with me.
Come with me, Lord.
Come with me, Lord.
Pick it up, pick it up.
Come and be close.
This is it. I feel you like the wind.
Feel you like the wind.
Blowing over my face.
Blowing over my face.
When I open my eyes.
When I open my eyes, I want to see you there.
The Lord thy God.
The Lord thy God in the midst of.
Oh, you're going home with the presence of the Holy Spirit. Can you feel His presence? Can you feel the power of God? That's the wind of the Spirit. He will save.
He will rejoice over thee with joy.
The Lord thy God.
God in the midst of.
He will rest in His joy and His love.
He will rest.
He will joy over you. This is my favorite part of the song.
Right by my side.
I feel it.
You are here, oh God.
Your presence. I know you don't understand what I'm talking about, but there's a presence.
That is what I know what I need.
That's what I need. Heaven, not just on Sunday, on Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday, on Thursday, on Friday, every place that I am.
I want to feel the presence of God standing right by me, standing right by me.
That's what we're going to talk about today, the wind of the Holy Spirit. The wind of the Holy Spirit. I feel you like the wind. I feel you like the wind. You know, the Holy Spirit is a person. But it's a strange person because he's a person that we cannot see. But when he moves, he's the invisible power behind everything that happens. In Genesis, I'm not really preaching. I don't really have points to share with you. I'm just this is not really the. If you should take time to read the book. It doesn't really have much. There are points, but that's not really what it's about. It's about flowing with the Holy Spirit in your life and allowing the Holy Spirit to take control of your life. When you read Genesis chapter 1, verse 2, the Bible describes the world in three states. It says the world was without form, lacking structure, lacking order. The world was disorganized. Is your life disorganized? Does your life lack structure? You can't see where to go. Do you have a bad foundation? Like, has it already begun bad? That's what it means to not have structure. Then it was void. Is your life empty? Is your church empty? I don't know if I'm allowed to say, is your bed empty? You people don't like my message this evening. The world was empty. The world was empty. I don't know what empty means to you. Where I'm standing is the first time when I became a full-time pastor, the first time I started a church as a full-time pastor. I started a church as a full-time pastor. And I brought, my father told me that I said I'm called, so I should go and start a church. So I asked that, where will I get money to start? He said, we don't use money to start it. He said, we use the Holy Spirit. That was on mood chain. At that time, the mood chain didn't belong to us. It was a night drinking spot or something. And I brought my canopy to this exact spot here. And there was only a slab in the sun. And I invited the people that I knew to come to church. The people who I invited, only two of them came. And then there were some other security people around guarding the construction site. So I added them to make a healthy six or seven people. That's void and without form. Then the Bible says there was darkness. Darkness means you don't know where you are going. You don't know what to do. You can't see what to do next. And I was under the canopy without form. Then the Bible says, and the Spirit of God moved. I don't know what is empty in your life. I don't know what is dark in your life. I don't know what lacks form. I don't know what seems hopeless. But the Spirit of God, when the wind of God moves, I don't have points to share with you, but I can tell you that the Holy Spirit, when He moves over your life, and you ask, how did it happen? Then the Bible says, and God said. You see, the Word of God, if you can understand, the Word of God doesn't work until the Holy Spirit has moved. Because when you speak without breathing, no sound comes out of your mouth. So your voice and your words don't actually travel without breath. You can speak words, you're just mouthing. Nobody can. So no matter how powerful what I'm saying is, it doesn't travel to you. And without the breath, which is the Holy Spirit, no matter how powerful the word is, it actually doesn't travel into your heart. That's why Daddy teaches us that the Holy Spirit transmits God's current plan for your life. But the problem with the Holy Spirit is that we can't see Him. That's why I love this song. You know, I told Daddy it's the best song he's ever written. Because, you know, when the song starts, it starts off exactly where we are, that, where are you, Lord?
Where are you, Lord?
Where can I find you?
Where can I find you?
But he said when two or three are gathered, so he must be here. He must be somewhere.
Right by my side.
Then the problem is, we cannot see him.
I wanna feel.
We cannot see whether he's here. I can see Daniel. I can see Joel. I can believe in Dan Joel because I can see him. I believe Joel exists because I see him and I know him. I can't see the Holy Spirit.
Presence with me.
So, where is he? And how do I learn how to live with somebody I can't see? I told you, when I got married, I had to understand how to live with somebody, and that's the person I can see. I had to learn how to turn lights off with the new person that I'm staying with. When you become born again, the Holy Spirit comes to live in you. The scripture tells us that if any man have not the Spirit, he's none of his. So as soon as you become one of God's, the Holy Spirit comes to live in you. But how to live with him? And how, because think about it, since you became born again, you've had the Holy Spirit in you. But how to flow with him and how to move with him is so difficult because you can't see him. He must be in this room. He must be here. He must be moving. He must be doing something. 30 years ago, when our prophet started a church in a classroom in Kolebu, there was an unseen force. As you were standing in front of five people speaking, there was an unseen force that has taken that little group, five people, can you imagine, to over 90 countries and hundreds of churches and thousands of pastors. There must be an unseen force that's working. So How can I have that same Holy Spirit work in my life and produce the results and the effects that I read of in the scripture, that I see in the lives of people that God is using? How can I have that in my life? And the way that the Bible shows us is by giving us symbols. I'm almost done preaching. The Bible gives us symbols that allow us to see how the Holy Spirit works. And we should understand that. Because sometimes we tell our friends, you are a rat. Now, it doesn't mean that the person is actually biologically a rodent. Are you with me? But what we are trying to say is that there's a characteristic of rats, which is snitching. And so when you snitch, we call you what? A rat. Sometimes you call a woman a female dog. It doesn't mean that she started barking and she's now a canine. No, it means that there's a certain ferocity and a certain ruthlessness and a certain wickedness which is being identified. And people are rightly or wrongly calling that person by that name so that you know how that person behaves. But it's not that the person is actually a dog. No. And we do that all the time. When you tell somebody you are a twerp is a pregnant fish. But you are not actually saying that the person has developed fins and can now breathe in water. Well, I hope not. But what you are saying is there are some characteristics in your behavior, and to assist a third party to understand how you behave, I'm using a word which you can relate with to allow you to relate with a person that you may not know. And so the Lord shows us, last week we looked at something. What did we look at? The rivers. The rivers of the Holy Spirit. When you understand how a river works, it's not that the Holy Spirit is a river or he's water. No. The Holy Spirit moves like a river. And if you want to flow with him, you have to learn how to understand what a river does, and you understand the Holy Spirit. We are almost done. We are 5 minutes away from the end. Now, one of the big things Jesus told us in John chapter 3 verse 5, he used a symbol of the Holy Spirit which shows us and opens a window into the operation of the Holy Spirit. And he says, John 3, 5, verily I say unto you, except a man is born of the water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. It will interest you to know that that word Spirit is the word wind. It's no different from verse 8. It's actually the same. In fact, the whole chapter is all talking about the wind. There's no word, there's no differentiation in the original Greek between the wind and the Spirit. It's all the wind. That which is born of the wind is wind. All of that is wind. That word is wind. And so in verse 8, he says, the wind blows where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but you cannot tell where it comes from and where it's going. So is everyone that is born of. The word born of is produced by. Any Christian who is produced by or worked on by the Spirit is has the effects of the wind of the Holy Spirit. Are you with me? Are you going on? Good. Now, what does it mean for the Holy Spirit to have a wind? That beautiful verse in John 3 verse 8 gives us everything that we need to know about the wind. And we're doing it in 5 minutes and we are closing. The first one is, the wind decides where he's blowing. The wind blows. You can't control the wind. The wind blows where it wants to. You can't control it. If you want to follow the Holy Spirit, you have to learn that you can't control the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit will control you. When a ship is sailing, the wind can blow, and the ship can desire to go in the opposite direction of the wind. But you can't fight the wind. You can only lift up your sails and try to catch the direction of the wind and follow the wind in that direction. Now, in your life, the Holy Spirit will have to decide. The Holy Spirit will have to lead. The Holy Spirit is the wind who chooses what happens next. In a service, it's the Holy Spirit that will have to choose what is going on next. What we are saying, what we are singing. That's the only way to cooperate with the Holy Spirit. If you want to decide, you can't have the wind of the Holy Spirit. If you want to choose, you can't have the Holy Spirit. He's a wind and he's blowing. And anybody who tries to control what the Holy Spirit is doing and what he's saying, you'll be out of place. And if in your life, there's never a time when the Holy Spirit leads you against your will and against your desires to do something else than what you want, then you are not flowing and you are not working with the Holy Spirit. Because the Bible says the Spirit of God will not strive with man forever because he's flesh. So the flesh cannot, Romans 8 tells us that the Spirit lusts against the flesh. So if you always follow what you want to do, you're not experiencing the wind. The wind. the wind. Which way is he blowing? Now, another interesting thing about the wind is that you can't really tell where it's going. It's right there. When the wind is blowing this way, I kind of just have to feel that I think the wind is going in this direction. It's not really clear. You can't really put your finger on it, but you just kind of feel that the wind is pushing me in this direction, and that's how the Holy Spirit leads you. You can't really tell, but you just feel. Have you ever had to make a decision? I just feel that this, the Holy Spirit is pushing me in this direction. I can't really put my finger on it. It's not, he didn't say a word to me, but I can tell that he's pushing me in this direction. That's the Holy Spirit. If you don't have that, you never have that edge, that feeling. You never gone somewhere that you felt you shouldn't be there. It never happened to you before. Since you got saved, you are just able to go everywhere. You've never listened to music and just felt the wind blowing you away from that song. It's not happened to you before. You've never had a friend that you are texting and there's a wind. No, you are pretending like you all don't understand what I'm talking about today. You've never felt a wind.
I felt it.
One day I asked one of my friends, before you went for hair, will you say that you were warned? Is it, at this point, we're in the crisis. Will you say, because I wanted to test whether the Holy Spirit speaks and saves us from things. And he told me, he paused. Yeah. Where is the wind blowing this evening? Where is he blowing? You know, when I got saved, I went to a, in my time, we used to call it drink ups. What are they called now? They're still called drink ups. Okay. You wouldn't know, Pastor Kenny, of course, because of the wind. You wouldn't know. Now, I was just trying to catch up with my old friend. I didn't know. I thought I was going to my friend's house, but I was going for a drink up. I didn't know. So I was there, and I told all of them I'm a Christian. So then they all started laughing. Oh, Charlie, come on for there. So we started chatting. I started feeling uncomfortable. Has that happened to you before? The wind is blowing. Then they brought drinks. I said, no. Fanta for me. I still was feeling uncomfortable. Not feeling okay. I feel that I shouldn't. That's what I said. I was saying, I feel you like the wind. I feel you like the wind. I don't know. I just feel I'm being blown in this direction. I just feel I'm being blown away. So I got up at a point. I said, you know, I don't think I can be here anymore. I don't think I can be friends with you guys anymore. Because the wind is blowing me in this direction. Many of us feel that edging, that guidance. Sometimes you wake up in the morning and there's no alarm, but you're up and it's 2 a.m. and you feel the wind. I feel him like the wind. And he's blowing you. He's trying to blow you into the closet. He's trying to call you to pray. You see, but if I say, how do you know? You can't really explain. You can't really put your finger on it. But what you can say is, the wind is blowing me. Sometimes you see somebody and the wind blows you towards the person. Go close. Go close. That's what happened to Philip. Join yourself to this chariot. Join yourself. Do you know why the place is quiet? Because everybody feels the wind. Yes, so is he that's born of the Spirit. Everybody, every Christian feels the wind. You know. I feel you like the wind. I can feel the wind blowing. You know. You know, as I'm even speaking, I'm remembering people who have been blown by the Spirit, who just ignore the wind. You know, the wind won't force you. It just blows. It just blows. And you know what you need to do to stop the wind? Close the window. You can just stop it. It's so light. Pushes you. This evening, I want to ask you, what is he pushing you? What is he saying? You are in love? No. Better to be in the wind than to be in love. Yes. No. Let's do a test. How many of you have been in a relationship that went wrong, but you felt the wind before it went wrong? Be honest. I'm one of them. I'll join you. Yeah. So we know the wind. You go for a job interview, They say, we would like to employ you, but you feel the wind. If you want to live a supernatural life, you need to feel the wind. Where is the wind blowing? What is the Lord saying? You are fixed. One lady came to see me. She said, I'm waiting for your brother. Your what? My brother. I couldn't believe it. So I called my brother that they're waiting for you. Yes, because somebody said she likes them. She's waiting for my what? My brother. Wow. I called him that they're waiting. I didn't know that they're waiting for you. And somebody was there saying, I love you. I want you. I need you. But her flesh, I don't know where she saw my brother because he's not around. But she said, I'm waiting for your brother. I couldn't believe my ears. I said, wow. That's the flesh. She's still waiting. She's still waiting. Up to this day, it's been some time now. And I think it's a long wait. Yes. But the wind, as soon as you accept that, that breeze will lead you. You start to be led by the Holy Spirit. I shouldn't be on this WhatsApp group. You shouldn't. You really should not. You should not be on it. You should have left. The wind was blowing. You're not supposed to be a Netflix subscriber. No, not somebody like you. You are better offline. You're better. You see, the church is very quiet because we all feel the wind. I feel the wind. When we come to church, how do we know what song to sing? Yes. We should prepare. Yes, we should have points and notes. It's very good, very important. Yes, we should know the list of songs that we'll sing. But if the worship leader doesn't learn how to move with the wind and to know which song the Holy Spirit wants us to sing, and it will be very gentle, it's like a breeze, but it's the key to maintaining the presence of God, is to follow the wind. That's why the Lord said, I will not go with you because you are stiff-necked people. I will not go with you. It's too difficult. Your neck is too strong. The scripture says your neck is like an iron sinew. I knew that thou art obstinate and your neck is like an iron sinew. Yes. If you look back at every disaster of your life, you find out that the wind was blowing. Yes, the wind was blowing. The wind was blowing. One day, you see, another thing about the wind is, if the wind is blowing on you, sometimes I can also feel it. Because I'm standing next to you, you see. So one day, the wind was blowing, and me, Pastor Nakoja, Pastor who? Good. And then the third party, let's call the person the third party, we're all feeling the wind, okay? So I told the person that I'm concerned. I don't feel. The person said, oh, it's the will of God. I have peace. Have you heard that before? Then Pastor Nakoja, in all his wisdom, said, you may convince us that you have peace, but it's the Holy Spirit you have to convince to change his mind about what he's saying. We are convinced, no problem. But you need to be. See, what I'm saying is that sometimes when God is leading, your flesh is so strong, you start to call God your flesh. Instead of admitting what is attracting you and what is guiding you. Instead of saying, look, the truth is that this is what is leading me and this is what's guiding me. And the wind of the Holy Spirit is blowing me in the opposite direction. But you argue. So Bishop Nakoja, in all his wisdom, he said, we are convinced. Okay, it's the peace. But in the end, you find out. What is he saying to you? When it's offering time, do you feel the wind? Yeah, offering time is windy. It's a windy time of the very, very windy time. Yes. You just walk in and just throw some. No. What is he saying? He may call you Jude. He may call you randomly. There will be no envelopes and no amounts, but he may ask you to put in 1,000 Ghana cedis. It's the wind. That's a strong wind. 1,000 Ghana cedis is a strong wind. That's a strong wind, yes. That's not a light wind, no. Oh, yes. One day I was crossing a zebra crossing outside my workplace. And the Lord told me to send an offering to the church. I should give an offering to him. And I knew it was God. Do you know why? The audacity to ask. what he asked me for. Yeah, the audacity. I knew that only God can ask. This is not the work of a man. Not of the will of flesh or the will of men, but of the will of God. There was the wind. It's ever so slight. When you even start arguing, say, oh, you know, and what, you've been justifying. Yeah, they will justify yourself, but God knows your heart, is he? You justify yourself. You'll be explaining, finding reason. You know, she changed. I know that she was whatever, and I know, and when prophet was preaching, he mentioned the issue almost as if you were in the relationship. Then, so you are very sure as you are there, you can't even say amen. The whole service is tense. What you are feeling is a gale. Do you know what a gale is? Put it up. G-A-L-E. A gale. You are feeling a gale. And you are tense. I'm explaining to you. Oh my God. I'm explaining to you how the Holy Spirit, if you want to flow with him, you're waiting for the heavens to open to hear a voice say, no, Jesus heard that voice from heaven two or three times. And he was the Son of God, full of holiness. You get it? I think you understand what I'm trying to say. Yes. So then, a gale, a strong current of air, a wind between a stiff breeze and a hurricane. The most violent gales are tempests. Yes, a tempest. As you're sitting in the church. Some of you, as I'm preaching, you can't even make eye contact. The tempest. Yeah, the sweating. There's all the wind. What you're experiencing is the wind of the Spirit. Yeah. It blows where it listed. No one knows where it's going or where it's coming from. So you start saying, but she's in the choir. Allow me to preach. And those of you who say that, we are judgmental. Okay? Like, why are you judging me? The answer to that question is yes. Yes, we are judging you. Because he that is spiritual judges all things. Yes, we are judging you. We are judging that from the looks of things, your decision is carnal. And your decision is not led by the Holy Spirit. Yes, we are judgmental. Yes. And those of you who say, we like to interfere in relationships. The answer is what? Yes. Because he that is spiritual, he judges all. Yes. Were you preaching about me? And the answer is?
Yes.
What do you think we are preaching about? Angels. We are preaching about you. Yes. Those of you who say, the people there don't like me. It's possible. It's possible. It's possible to not be liked. Yes. It's possible. So anyway. Don't you be explaining? But she's in the choir. Daddy knows her. But Josh knows her. I saw him talking to her. She's close. He even brought two buses. You see, all these are the mental arguments against the tempest and the wind of the Holy Spirit. But what you have to realize, as you sit in the church and the word of God is coming, nobody has mentioned your name. The reason you are under pressure and you are tense is because the Holy Spirit is moving. And if you want to understand how he is, you're going to have to learn to follow that breeze. The tempest, that's the wind of the Holy Spirit. No one can say, Ecclesiastes 11:5, no one can say where the wind is going. And that's how the Bible describes the work of God. Yeah, as thou knowest not the way of the Spirit. Give me NASB. As thou knowest not what is the way of the Spirit. As you don't know the path of the wind and how bones are formed in the womb of the pregnant woman, so you do not know the activity of God who makes all things. And I can't determine where the wind will go. I can't tell what will happen next. I can't tell if God will choose to use you or you choose to use you or you choose to use you. Choose to use you. I can't tell. Or if you choose to use all or none. I can't tell. Those where he lives. Autonomous wind. It's a powerful wind. It's the wind of the Holy Spirit. It's the wind that brings life. The wind brings life into everything that it blows on. That's what you are looking for. Life. 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 You remember Ezekiel 37? When the Bible says, the valley was full of bones. Many, many, many dry bones. Then he told Ezekiel, son of man, prophesy to the bones. Which is usually where we end. And we say he prophesied to the bones. thou knowest. Verse 4. Very quickly, my dear, up there. Very quickly. Verse 4. And he said unto me, prophesy to these bones and say, O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Verse 5. Then he said, thus saith the Lord unto these bones, behold, I will cause breath to enter into you and you shall live. I'll cause what? Breath. And you will live. Verse 6. And I will lay sinews upon you. Sinews is the something flesh. Something, some medical, something. I'm an art student. I cannot follow that. And I'll bring flesh on you. And then I will cover you with skin, because they were bones. So he will make the body, cover it with skin, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord. Verse 7. So I prophesied as I was commanded, and there was a noise, and the bones came together, bone to bone. Next, verse 8. And when I beheld, the sinews and the flesh came upon them, and the skin came up. So now it was a full body, it was no longer bones. But there was no breath in them. Verse 8. Verse 9. Then he said, prophesy unto the wind. Prophesy unto the wind. Son of man, and say to the wind, come from the four winds. Yeah. Archbishop Idahosa used to teach on the four winds of God. Come from the four winds. I don't know what it's about, but I heard of it. Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain that they may live. Life. You may meet Christian in your lifetime. Person that you meet. Actually, not even a believer. It's happened to me many times. And as a pastor, a man of God who believes in the Bible, you have no hope. The state of the sin and the corruption in the person, you have no hope. It's happened to me before. He's on drugs. He's sleeping around. He's uneducated, dropped out of school, hopeless, wicked, violent, on his way to jail. Then you go away and you come back later. He's wearing a white long sleeve shirt. He's wearing black trousers. And he's playing bass guitar in the church. And you wonder, what happened to the dry bones? What changed the person? Is it the hall? Is it the pulpit? Is it the music? No. It's the wind of the Holy Spirit that has blown on the person that is changing the person. Sometimes you go to a church and you hear somebody preaching and everything is intellectually perfect and a lot of verses which are connecting and making a lot of sense. And a lot of you can sense a very intelligent person, but there's something empty in the atmosphere. Then you travel. You come back some years later or some months later to the same service. You see that young man that you knew all those long, many years or months ago. And he's holding the mic. And he's speaking. And he sounds the same. The voice sounds the same. The points are even the same. But there's something else that is blowing in the church. And the atmosphere when he's preaching. And when he finishes preaching, you ask that, what were the points? You're not even sure exactly what exactly were the points that were made. But what you can tell is that there's an invisible, unseen, inexplicable force that is working. The wind of the Holy Spirit. The wind of the Holy Spirit. When I gave my life to Christ, me and my friend, where we came to church on Friday night, so that it was all night, so that the all night to see that we came, especially first offering, which usually happens just before midnight. And you go forward. So when you go forward, everybody will know that you are there. So we went forward and gave our offering. Then we went to sit down. Stop smiling as if you don't understand what I'm saying. So I was standing with my friend. We had other plans for Friday night, which doesn't concern you. And then the pastor was praying. Was preaching. For some reason, I don't know why he was preaching, but he was preaching. And as he was preaching, I was surprised. I wasn't even listening to what he was preaching. I was on my phone, waiting for the right moment. When people stand up like this, then you just go out. Then, I don't know what happened, but he decided to do an altar call in the middle of the thing. I don't even know if it was an all-night, but it was late in the night. I don't remember what program to. I did an altar call somehow, and suddenly, I stood up. and I found my hand, which I've not intended to raise. My hand was up like this, yes. Then my friend said, what did he do? What did he do? I don't know what I do. And I went forward. My father was the pastor of the church. I walked forward in the middle of the aisle to go and give my life. Everybody was looking at me. What is pushing me forward? What is pushing you? What is changing you? It's an unseen force. And I gave my life to God. When I came back to my seat, the guy I was with asked me. Very recently I saw him. He asked me, oh, what's up? Because trying to find out, is the plan still, what's going on? The way, and I told him, Charlie, I don't know. I didn't know even what to say. That's the last time I think I've even been with him in a certain way since. That's many, many years ago. What changes? It's not the house you grew up in or the books in the library in your house. No, it's the wind of the Holy Spirit. It's the wind of the Holy Spirit. Two Sundays ago, prophet was preaching and he came down the steps and came to walk. I don't even remember the point that he was making. But as he walked next to where I was sitting, the whole atmosphere just, you see, there was a rushing calmness, violent and at the same time peaceful. Like a whirlwind around the man. That's the presence, and you are not sure. So I turned and I realized that everybody in the front had become still. Everybody next to me, there was a stillness. There's a power that works. And I know you can't see him. I know he doesn't have a face that you can identify. But I tell you, it's more real than the air that you are breathing. It's real, that power. That's what gets people saved. It's the wind of the Holy Spirit that changes people, that touches people's lives. It's the wind of the Holy Spirit. It's not what you say. I know you've heard me tell this story. I'm going to tell it again. Billy Graham was in Liverpool for crusade. 6 weeks. After a few days, the newspaper started to attack him. And they said he uses psychological torture and pressure to make the people come forward to give their lives to Christ. And they said because when he finishes preaching, there's a song that they sing that creates emotional pressure and works on the minds of the people. And it's some form of chanting and kundalini something. Yeah, these were the newspapers in England, Liverpool. And the song that they used to sing was, just as I am without one Methodist choir. But that thy blood was shed for me, and as thou bidst me come to thee, O Lamb of God, I come. And thousands of people. You know, Billy Graham's preaching there. First of all, he doesn't have a moving mic. Is that stationary? I don't know. He's just standing there, and he's just standing there. He's talking. You know, Benny Hinn says he was one of the organizers of a Toronto crusade when he was part of the Catacombs Church that he was in Toronto. He said they organized the crusade. He said when Billy Graham starts to preach, the whole room becomes still. He said it doesn't matter how large the stadium is, everybody becomes still. He said, and I was convinced that I've met somebody who has a personal relationship with the Holy Spirit. Yes, yes, yes. So the newspapers accused him. So he said, okay. He told his musician, today, Karoba Tiada, no song. You know, this story touches my heart every time. He said, no song. So he finished, said, if you want to give your heart to him, come. And he put the mic down. He took the mic out of the stand and put it on the pulpit. And then he stepped back and bowed his head in prayer. The crowds, the multitudes, because you see, it's not the song, it's not the choir, it's not a psychological tool. No, it's a person blowing like a tempest and a cyclone. Nothing can stand in his path. It's the work of the Holy Spirit. The next morning, the newspaper said, please bring back the music. The silence is worse. I pray for you that you have the wind of the Holy Spirit in your life. I pray for you. But I preach.
I preach.
So I know. You mention verses, you give points, then you sit down. You mention verses, you give points, sit down. Mention verses. Is it about that too? No, no, no. But what we are preaching is 5-7. We all preach the same things. We all preach the same things. It's the wind. It's the breath. The wind that is blowing, the gale, the cyclone, the tempest, the hurricane, the wind. The most stony heart. Trust me, you can burst into tears. The most stony heart, the most hardened person, the Holy Spirit's wind can change the person. That's what the Bible says. It's the Holy Spirit who will convict or convince men of sin. The most difficult thing to tell somebody is that he's done something bad. No. When I was young, a Toblerone chocolate got missing from the fridge. It became the biggest issue of my home. And up till today, we don't know who took that Toblerone from the fridge. Oh, yes. Massive investigations were carried out. Interrogations and questioning. There was even torture at a point. To find out who took up till today, it's a myth in my house. It was one of the biggest issues. And that's a missing chocolate. Yes, my father himself carried out all those investigations. It was who took it. And as we stand here now, it's not easy to find out who did it. When we start telling you, they say, why wonder that church? They're always judging you. They're always doing this. They're doing that. And why? And whatever. And what they force you to come. And they told you that. And they made you do this. I'm this brother. I'm this brother. Why? Can I worship God in my room? It's between me and God. I'm this brother. All those things. Because no one can tell you, you are a sinner. You are on your way to hell. Nobody can tell you, you are living in sin. You are living in sin. The soul that sins, he shall die. It sounds like a story to you. The soul that sins, he shall die. Be thou holy, for the Lord thy God is holy. You cannot live life in fornication. You cannot be drinking and be coming to church. You cannot go to nightclubs and come to church. You cannot have worldly friends and come to church. Your life has to change. It will not work, I'm telling you, it will not work. It will not work. But no matter how they say it, it sounds like a story. Until the wind starts to blow. Then the Bible says, he will convict men of sin. Of sin. And that's dangerous, eh? To only be convinced of your sin. That's depression. That's what leads to suicide. So he has to convince men of righteousness. Here, it takes a lot for God to convince you that you are righteous and truly holy. That you are as good as Jesus. It's difficult. It's difficult, yes, it's difficult. That you are as good as Jesus. In the realm of the Spirit, you've never sinned. You are holy. And the righteousness of God, God imputed righteousness to you. And that when he hung on the tree, your sins were upon him. And when he died, when he said it is finished, he was talking about your sin, your judgment, your punishment. He said it is finished. What a story. What a story. What a story. That we are not saved with bulls and goats or perishable things like silver and gold, but by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. What a story. You say God has called you. You are going to Taiwan to tell people this story. That there's a Jewish guy who died, and because he died, you are fine. No, it's not a story you can convince men with words. No, no, no. But when the wind begins to blow, when the wind begins to blow, that's the problem with outreaches. There's no wind. There's no wind. We need more windy Christians. We need more people who carry the presence of God. Oh, yes. Righteousness. You are righteous and truly holy. You are perfect. Yes, your sins have been forgiven. If you confessed your sins, he is faithful and just to forgive you and to cleanse you. Your life can change. You can live life without fornicating. You can live life without masturbation. You can live life without pornography. You can overcome it. I don't care how much Satan has lied to you. The Holy Spirit can convict you of righteousness. He can show you how to. The Bible says, he leadeth me in the paths of righteousness. It is possible to overcome. All your friends that you think you are tied to, there can come a day that you'll be surprised you're even part of that group. God can lead you away into what he has for you. You don't have to sleep with an older man for money. You don't have to do it. I'm telling you. There's another way. There's a righteous way. Righteousness is still important in the church. It's still something that we must aspire to. It's not something we should ignore. It's not a topic we should walk away from. The Holy Spirit must convict us of righteousness. The Holy Spirit must convict us of judgment. You'll be judged. How do I know? The wind. How do I know there's a judgment seat? I've not seen it, but the wind. It blows. Usually when you go home, YouTube a cyclone or a hurricane. You see a big house, big story building with foundations. And you see the wind coming. The hardest heart, the most wicked of sinners, the wind. So I pray, you know, I hope God has spoken to you. I pray for you as we close. The wind of the Spirit, the wind that blows. We didn't actually get to what the wind does. This is just what the wind is. You should pick up the book and read. It's too deep to go into. You should buy the book. The fact that you haven't bought the book is a problem. The wind of the Holy Spirit, it blows where it listed. It blows, first of all. It blows. It has power in it. Then it blows where it chooses. Have you not chosen that this leader, he will become my best pastor? What happened? Because you cannot list the wind. You cannot describe to the wind where to blow. No. And then the guy that you said, he will not amount to nothing. Yes. Yes. One pastor told somebody, Joshua, you will not amount to much. Oh, and I understand him. Based on the facts on the table. I get it. Makes sense. You will not amount to much. But the wind, where it listeth. You can't tell where it's coming from. Where is the Holy Spirit coming from? And you can't tell where he's going. Which church will he move to next? Which individual he suddenly descend on and start to use? Who's it going to be? I don't know. You can't tell. So is everyone. Then he says, but you hear the sound. We don't have time for the sound of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is, you can't see, but he has a sound. That's his voice. That's why we sing, I love your voice. You know, you
led me to the fire.
Hey, today you are earning your salary. Beautiful.
In darkest days, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God.
Your voice. You know, Solomon writes about the dove. He says, oh my dove, I think it's Ecclesiastes, Songs of Solomon, chapter 3, I think. Oh dove that dwellest in the clefts of the rock, let me see your countenance. Let me hear your voice. 2:14. Let me see your countenance. Let me hear your voice. The dove is the Spirit. Let me hear your voice. Let me hear. The Holy Spirit has a sound. He speaks. He has a sound. You know the wind. You can't. You just say, it's a sound. It's a sound. His voice. He wants to speak to you. We don't have time to go into that, but I want to just prophesy to you. The Holy Spirit wants to speak to you. You know, if you are sensitive, this is what Jesus said. Why are your hearts hardened? If your hearts are not hard, you actually realize that in this service, the Holy Spirit has spoken to you. Oh, yes. I know what he's asking me to do. I can tell. I'm hearing his voice. And you too, you are hearing his voice. He has a sound. Yes, and he has effects. You know, it's amazing. Sometimes you come to church. I'm closing with this one. This is just by the way. You come to church and the wind of the Holy Spirit is blowing. Increase your volume. I can't hear what you're playing. The wind can blow that way, and then it touches you in a way that you can't explain. I need an usher. And now, then you ask yourself, like, What made, we are all educated, what made the person fall down? What makes? What? Why is he on the floor? What power makes somebody, what makes something shake? Have you come into the garden and seen the tree shaking? What is, you can't see the wind, but you can see that the wind is making somebody shake. And sometimes you come to a church service and somebody is shaking. Somebody is shaking. And it's the power of the Holy Spirit that comes upon the person. It's the power of the Holy Spirit that comes upon the person. And that's the wind. That's the wind. That's the wind of the Holy Spirit. Maybe you don't understand. But when you see a tree shaking, the tree doesn't shake for no reason. The tree shakes because the wind is blowing. So never feel uncomfortable when you come to a church and you come to the house of God and some people are falling and some people are trembling and some people are shaking. It's part of the presence of the wind. The wind makes things move. Jeremiah 5:22 says, I am the Lord. Will you not tremble at my presence? Fear ye me not. Will you not tremble at my presence? The presence of God makes you tremble because the presence of God is a wind. The presence of God makes you fall because the presence of God is a wind. The presence of God can make the place shake because it's a wind. Never feel uncomfortable. I'm just teaching you. Expect a move from God. Expect the wind to blow. Expect the power of God to flow because the Holy Spirit is a wind. The Holy Spirit is a wind. He moves. Expect His move. Expect the anointing. Expect the power of God. Watch to see what He'll do. Watch to see what He'll say. When I was sitting down 2 weeks ago, and prophet came, when he walked past, I just went still. All the hairs, that's what Job said. Job said, the Spirit passed before me, and all the hairs on my head stood up. Yeah. All the hairs on my head stood up. I can't explain it. You know, Ari Torrey, the great Ari Torrey, he writes that he was with Charles Finney. And he said, Charles Finney opened his Bible and began to preach. And there was suddenly, everybody went quiet. Thousands of people, everybody went quiet. And every people started to weep and to cry. And he said, that's the wind. That is what you call the wind of the Spirit. That's the presence of the Holy Spirit. And he said, you can never forget those moments. Let's flow with the wind. I don't want to be in a church that doesn't accept the wind. No, you can start. Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. I live for you alone. Every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your. Then you find out that the wind is not blowing in that direction. So you just have to switch. Come breathe in me. You have to let, if you're a worship leader, I'm telling you, you have to know my life. That's what He's doing. Take over. Come on, move, Holy Spirit. You have to know He's not going in this direction. Come breathe in me, and I will rise. Lift your hands. Lift your hands. Only the wind of the Holy Ghost. Here I am waiting. We're done, we're done. You can stand to your feet. Abide in me, I pray. Is anybody hungry? Is anyone hungry for the Holy Ghost? Here I am longing. Here I am longing. I'm so hungry for you. The Holy Spirit is moving. 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 Hide me in your love. Please hide me in your love and bring me to my knees. Please bring me to my knees. I want to know Jesus more and more. May I know Jesus more and more. If you are hungry, before the Holy Ghost. Lift your hands, close your eyes, and let's sing this wonderful prayer up into the heavens. Come breathe in me.
Come breathe in me.
All my life.
All my life.
Oh, what a wonderful prayer.
Take over.
Come breathe.
I will
Holy Ghost. Thank you for your wind. The wind is blowing. The wind is blowing. The wind is blowing. The wind is blowing. Wind is blowing. The 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 wind is blowing. It's blowing. It's blowing. It's blowing. Flow. 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 Move, Spirit, move. Please do what you want to do. Softly, softly. We just offer ourselves as vessels. You can do. Oh, I love you, Holy Spirit. I love you, Holy Spirit. Move. Holy Spirit, why don't you move? Spirit, do what you want to do. We just offer ourselves as vessels. Difficulty, a situation, something is difficult to come out of, but you can sense the wind of the Spirit leading you out of it. Come. Come right now. I want to pray with you. Quickly, come to the front. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Come from your seat. I'm waiting. God bless you. Come. Come quickly, quickly, quickly.
Yield yourself.
Come quickly. Freedom is here. To the Holy Spirit. I sense His power.
Let Him have His way.
I need to turn my back on the world. I need to turn my back on my friends. I need to stop watching pornography. I need to stop sleeping around. I need to change my friends. I need to change my surroundings. I need to walk away from some things, Pastor. Come, the Holy Spirit is bringing you Himself.
Heal yourself to the anxious of God. Yield yourself to the Holy Spirit. Let Him have His way. Wave after wave. Wave after wave. The glory of the Lord fills this whole. Wave after wave.
hands. And the congregation as well, just lift your hands. That's what the Spirit says. In a few seconds, the wind of the Spirit is about to blow right here at the front. It's about to blow over your life. It's about to blow over your soul. He's setting you free. I can already see him moving. He's already moving. Receive it now. At the front, the wind is blowing. Receive it right now. Receive freedom. Receive freedom. Ashes. Receive freedom. Receive freedom. Receive freedom. Receive freedom. Receive freedom. It's moving. It's moving like a gale, like a tempest, like a tempest, like a tempest. Be free. Be free. Be free. Every chain is broken. Every chain is broken. Every chain is broken. Today is the last day. This is the move and the touch and the power of the wind of the Holy Ghost. 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 Shh, ashes. Not too much movement. Shh, my dear, my dear. Shh, be quiet, be quiet, be quiet. Shh, lift your hands. Lift your hands. Three, two, one. Be free. Be free. Be free. Be free. Be free. Be free. And when he had breathed on them, he said, "Receive ye the Holy Ghost." Be free. Be free. Be free. This is the air I breathe. From pornography, every demon of pornography, every demon of masturbation is coming out you now in Jesus' name. Every spirit of temptation, every spirit of lust that has plagued you and has held on to your ankle for many years, from today, receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. He's the only one who can keep you from falling. And to him who is able to keep you from falling, it's the Holy Spirit. Let that wind blow over you right now in the name of Jesus. Be free from worldliness and carnality. Be free from drugs. Be free from smoking cigarettes and weed. I command every spirit of drug use and addiction to come out now in the name of Jesus. I declare freedom over you. Receive the wind of the Holy Ghost. Receive freedom from bad friends and bad company, the company of armed robbers and the company of thieves and wicked men and drunkards and drug dealers. Receive freedom in the house of God, for whosoever the Son shall set free is free indeed. It's free indeed. Every chain is broken. Every chain is broken in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. We're lost without you, Lord. I'm lost without you. Lift your hands and thank him for freedom. Oh, whosoever the Son shall set free is free indeed. I command you freedom in the name of Jesus. I command your freedom in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for your power. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your wind. In Jesus' name. Thank him. Lift your hands and thank him. Say, Lord, I thank you. I'm free. I'm free. And declare what you are free from. Say, I thank you. I'm free from this. I thank you. Today is the last day. I thank you. You are setting me free. I thank you that the chains are broken. I thank you that I'm free indeed. I give you all the praise and I give you all the glory. Oh, Holy Spirit, I want to have you in my life. I want your presence. I want to be free. I want to know you. I want to be closer to you. I want to live for you. I want to serve you. I thank you, oh God, for what you have done tonight in my life. I know that I can never be the same. Because of your power, because of your hand, I'm free. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Father, I thank you for these ones. Thank you for your power over them. Thank you for the freedom that is in the Spirit. For where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. I thank you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. No, don't clap, don't clap. Thank you, you can go back to your seats. God bless you. You're here, please keep standing. Please keep standing, please keep standing, please keep standing. You're here today, you don't know Jesus as your Lord, your personal Savior. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit has touched your heart to give your life to Jesus Christ. Maybe you came here today because somebody invited you, but as you've come into the presence of God, you realize how much you need him. If you're here like that, I want you to lift up your right hand. Pastor, pray with me. I want to change my life. I want to give my heart to Jesus Christ. Maybe you think you're a Christian, but today you find out. If you die today, sure, you found out in the presence of God how far you are from him. Pastor, pray with me. Help me to find Jesus. Maybe you are like me. You grew up in a Christian home, but you know in your heart you are not saved. Lift up your right hand high above your head. High above your head. I'm watching for your hand. God bless you. If you've lifted up your hand, do one more thing for me. Come all the way to the front. I want to pray with you. All the way. My brother, my sister, come. All of you. I want to pray with you right here at the front. You can come like the way that the first group came. I need Jesus. My sister, it's not too late to find Jesus. It's not too late to find Jesus. Let the Holy Spirit work on you. Let him have his way. You are lost without him. You have nothing without him. You are nothing. You are nothing without the power of God. You are nothing without the presence of God. You are nothing without salvation. You are nothing without the cross. You are nobody without the cross. You need Jesus. Leave your seat and come. Allow the wind to blow you. Allow the Holy Spirit to bring you. This is the day your life changes. This is the day your life is turned around. This is the day things begin to happen. This is the day when everything that you used to be is no longer who you are. Come all the way from your seat. Jesus is using my hand to stretch out. He's using my voice to speak, and he's calling you to come. Come to him. Come and give your heart to him. He can pick you out of the miry clay and set your feet on a rock to stand. I'm waiting for you a few more seconds. If you are coming, I'm waiting for you. Jesus wants to save you. He wants to touch your life. I remember the day I gave my life to Christ was in a church service just like this in the evening. And I lifted up my hand. My life was never the same. I don't know who you are, but there are a few more people. I'm waiting for you. I'm about to pray. My time is fast spent. Allow the wind of the Holy Spirit to touch you and to bring. There are no words that can convince you. Allow the Holy Spirit himself to touch you and to bring you to him. And I know your life will never be the same again. God bless you. God bless you, my brother. God bless you. Anyone else coming quickly? I'm about to pray. Please bow your heads. Congregation, bow your heads. Let's all pray together in this room. What a beautiful moment. What a great night to be saved. Everybody bow your heads all over this place. I want you to repeat this prayer after me. Everybody say, Heavenly Father, I come to you today just as I am. I'm a sinner. Have mercy on me. Wash me in your blood. Come into my heart. Be the master of my life. Save me, Jesus. Change me, Jesus. Now say to the devil, say, Satan, I will no longer serve you. Oh, I will no longer follow you. From this moment, I belong to Jesus. From today, I'm born again. From today, I have a new life. Now say, thank you, Lord, for saving me. Now lift your hand, say, Lord, send your Holy Spirit to come and live in me, to help me to be holy, to serve you, and to follow you. I say, thank you, Lord, for saving me. In Jesus' name I pray. And everyone said, amen. Now, thank you so much. God bless you. There's a lady there who wants to speak to you. She has a gift for you from our prophet. Our pastor is Bishop Dagwood Mills, and he has a free gift for everybody who gives their life to Christ in this service. So I want you to go and receive that gift, and then you'll go right back to your seats. So God bless you. Please follow the sign right there. It's going to take just a few seconds, and then you'll be back with us. God bless you. Oh, what a blessing. Lift your hands and thank him for his blessing, his blessed presence. His presence is a blessing. Lord, we thank you for what you have done with us this evening. In Jesus' name I pray. And everyone said amen. God bless you. Can I have some offering baskets? Thank you. You may be seated. Offering baskets. Oh, I feel the wind of the Spirit. I feel the wind of the Spirit. Sing that verse again, the wind. I feel you like the wind.
Right by my side, here with me.
Come and be close.
Come with me, Lord.
Come and be close, Lord.
Come and be close. Feel you like the wind blowing over my face.
Something special. Bow your heads. Holy Spirit, lead us to give what you want us to. In Jesus' name. Amen. I want to take a special offering of 500 Ghana cedis from just a few people, about 10 people. Quickly. 500 Ghana cedis. You can give by mobile money. Can I have some envelopes? I think I may need some envelopes. But you can give by mobile money so that we don't need envelopes. You believe the Holy Spirit wants you to give 500 Ghana cedis. I want you to come to me quickly. 500 Ghana cedis. I want 10 people to come and give 500 Ghana cedis. 10 people. I'm waiting for you. Even if you are, don't wait for envelopes, come. Yeah, if it's mobile money, just come. Come stand here quickly. 10 people. Have you sent it already? You haven't, so send it and tap your phone on the offering basket. God bless you, Mother Bidia. God bless you, sir. I need 10 people. I have 3 so far, I think. Everywhere, 4.
Every place that
5.
I want to feel the presence of God standing right by
6.
Standing right by.
You know, the verse keeps coming to me. Those who sow to the Spirit. The presence of God is here. Oh, our convener. You're welcome. Oh. Convener, if you can, please. Thank you, please. God bless you.
Everywhere that I go.
Have I got my 10? Who is coming? 7.
Face that.
Those who sow to the Spirit, that's what I was hearing. The presence of God is here, so before it leaves, come and sow quickly. Quickly. I don't know if I need an envelope, but if you want an envelope, you can come. 8. I need 2 more people, quickly. 10. 9, I'm moving on. 8, if you are coming, stand up so I know you are coming. 7, 6, 5, God bless you, 1 more. Good, run.
Your presence.
That's what I need.
That's what I need.
All right. Okay, Lord, 200 Ghana cedis. 200 Ghana cedis. 200 Ghana cedis, come. 200, I would like to get 20 people to give me 200 Ghana cedis. Come and sow into the Spirit. Sow it. Now, somebody can be counting. Somebody will ask me why. I don't know. The wind. I feel led to take an offering of 200 Ghana cedis. And some people feel led to give an offering of 200 Ghana cedis. That's how it works. If you are sensitive to the wind. 200 Ghana cedis.
Everywhere that I. Every place that I am, I want to feel the presence of God.
11, 9 more, 9 more. I'm waiting for you. 9 more. Do I need envelopes? I don't need envelopes. If you want to give, you want an envelope so you bring it later, you can come with me. But I need 9 of you, quickly.
That is what
you need an emblem.
Everywhere I want to feel the presence of God.
Oh yes. Oh yes, what an anointing. Wow.
Standing right by.
How many? Who's coming? 16. I need 4 more people. and their envelopes if you need them. Your presence. Is that not what you need? Everybody learn how to sing in church. We are singing. This is what's happening now. Everybody is singing.
Every place that I am, I want to feel the presence of God.
Ghana cities, there are a lot of you, 100 cities. Come quickly. In your presence.
In your presence there is life.
Come for a joy. Don't stand there. Stand there.
Expressions of your love.
Revelations.
Revelations of your power.
Cities, I'm calling you. I'm calling you in the spirit. 100 Ghana cities. Quickly. Come on, how many of you love His presence? In your presence.
In your presence.
I am content.
I am content. In
100 Ghana cities. Those who sow to the spirit, some of the spirit reap life. Your spirit has made me, and your breath has given me life.
Expressions of your love.
Revelations. Those who sow to the spirit. I can't explain it to you, but those who sow to the spirit, they reap life. They reap life.
In your presence I can breathe.
A love song offering.
A love song offering. I'm in the presence of my King.
I'm waiting. Cities. Now there are more of you. There are five more of you. Give me five more. There are five more of you. Come quickly. I'm over time.
This time.
Five of them. Come for it quickly. I'm calling you. Quickly. I have five. I'm calling for you. It's not you. Five. It's for my church members. Come, five of you. Come quickly, I'm waiting for you. God bless you, my dear. Take it off. Come, I have five. I have five, only five, and then I don't have
it. God bless you, my dear.
I have two more. Yes, that matters.
Revelations of your power and mind.
Oh,
in your
the Spirit calling.
Hear the Spirit call out to every nation.
Come, let us worship Him. Visitation. This is it. This is it. It's not later on. It's not in the past. This is the moment. 50 Ghana cities. I'm closing quickly. 50 Ghana cities. Come, let's enter into His presence. Come, let's enjoy His glory. Let's bow down and worship Him.
Because I sing it.
Spirit is falling.
Spirit is falling.
Lord, we love you.
now. Oh, we got 4 minutes more. Let's take out a love offering. What's a love offering? It's anything else, a booster. 10 cities, 5 cities, 6 cities, 7 cities, 8 cities, 2 cities, 1 city, all coins. Everything less than 10 with coins. If you have more than 10, that's also fine. But I want everyone to take something out. Everybody take something to add up, something to add on. Why? I don't know why. I just feel the wind blowing and I feel that we should. Yes, we do. This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. For the King is here. For the King is here. And we're tithers. Yeah, we'll come to that. Now rise up with your offerings and come. Everybody with something else, come quickly. Everybody with something else. Come on, Mr. Drummer, pick it up. This is holy ground.
This is holy ground. We're standing on holy ground. For the Lord is here, and when He is, is holy.
Come on, we are standing. In Christ and an impartation of the blessing of the body of Christ into your body. The body of Christ. Bible says, likewise, he took a cup and said, this is my blood in the New Testament. It is for the remission of sins. I pray, Lord, that every sin that we have committed, every mistake that we have made, every evil seed in the ground ready to bring forth an evil harvest, by the power of the blood, cleanse us, wash us, and help us to come before you perfect. Help us to escape the punishment for sin because of the cross and because of your blood. In Jesus' name, the blood of Jesus. Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for the blessing of the cross. Let every good thing that comes with communing with you and with your body and with your blood, let that blessing rest upon us as we go home. In Jesus' name I pray. And everyone said, amen.